All right, it's 10 in the morning on a Wednesday, and today I'm going to be reacting to Tyler, the Creator's Cherry Bomb for the first time ever. As always, the uncut will be on Patreon, so go join that if you want. And yeah, let's get into the video.
This is hard.
Oh.
This is really good.
I like to follow the rules, and that's just who I am.
This track is all over the place. Holy. Oh, what? Why is it? I do this all the time. It's always on shuffle. That was amazing. I was not expecting the kind of rock energy that he went with on that track. Obviously, those distorted screams in the back, that heavy riff. I liked the little switch-up sections in there too, where it's more stripped back and it just has the percussion and the little claps in there. Overall, I like the energy on it. So let me just, for anyone who's new here, I have heard Wolf, I've heard Flower Boy, Igor, and Call Me If You Get Lost. I haven't heard Bastard or Goblin. Or Cherry Bomb, of course. I mean, the production was kind of rough, which I kind of expected, because I have heard some stuff about this album, how the production is kind of, like, it has this kind of rough DIY aesthetic to it. But yeah, I actually really enjoyed that. I know a lot of people don't really like this album that much, but so far, I mean, through one track, pretty impressive. I like the energy. Production was very full in the headphones, a very full sound. And yeah, no clue what the lyrical content was about, but overall, in terms of the sound, it was enjoyable. So yeah, let's keep going. I like that sub bass, that's dope. Really dissonant synth, holy. Who is that? Super introspective track. Okay, second track was great once again. Kind of a really introspective track too. I don't know if that was a feature or who that voice was, but it seemed like another side of Tyler telling himself not to mess this up. So yeah, overall, cool track. Really sinister, really unsettling, a lot of dissonant stuff, and like at some points the drums were, it felt like they were off time with what was going on in the synths and the piano chords and stuff like that. Really aggressive energy once again, which I gotta get used to because I am more used to like a kind of a more chill Tyler, with like the Igors and the Flower Boys and stuff like that. But yeah, I mean, I think he's nailing this aggressive sound very well, and the production is just super full. Like those synths that came in, great. Perfecto. Perfecto al mundo. Is that the saying? I don't know. Super distorted. Everything's distorted. But then he just switches up with these nice piano chords.
First class, but I feel like coach.
I don't wanna.
These transitions. Another super like blown out and distorted track. I don't know how to feel about it. I feel like at some points I was liking it, and it kind of contributed to the vibe of the album. But then at some points it felt maybe just a little bit too distorted and blown out. Everything was just super, super loud in the mix. There wasn't much levels or dynamics to anything. Like, I still kind of like this aggressive energy. I'm just kind of torn because I don't really know how to feel about that song. Because, I don't know, it's going to take another listen to really decide if I like that super blown out and distorted sound or not. But lyrically, talking about you can have all this stuff, but you still feel like you're not worth anything, or kind of stuff like that. Like, you're in first class, but you still feel coach. Obviously, kind of the hook there. So yeah, lyrically, it's still that kind of introspective Tyler that we usually get, which I always enjoy.
So yeah, I'm just trying to get used to this sound because it's so different from Flower Boy, Igor, even Calling Me If You Get Lost, and even Wolf too. It's very different from Wolf. It's kind of crazy because Wolf definitely feels more like Flower Boy and Igor, but this came out after Wolf, so it's kind of, it feels like kind of just a one-off in between these albums, Wolf, Flower Boy, Igor, and Call Me If You Get Lost. Obviously, I haven't listened to his two first albums. This might be similar to those, I'm not too sure, but it's definitely a very, very different vibe from all of his other stuff. Closer, kind of close to Wolf, but the production really sets it apart in the fact that it's like super blown out and distorted. In a car called Life, it's a lame route. Going nowhere fast, you think that you're not, because you never hesitate to get banged out. Vocal effects kind of weird. Like, Tyler has such a great deep voice, and this vocal effect kind of ruins it for me. It's this really metallic, like tinny almost kind of sound to it. I'm not really liking the vocal effect on this. I'm gonna give it a chance though. Maybe it'll switch up and do something else. Okay, that was a strange short track. Probably not my favorite. Probably my least favorite, actually. Once again, the vocal effect, just not a big fan of it. I think Tyler's just raw voice. It sounds weird. His clean, unedited, unfiltered voice is his strength, one of his main strengths. And I think that vocal, I mean, obviously there is times where he like pitches it up and it actually works, but that tinny kind of vocal effect really didn't do it for me. And the production, there really wasn't that much interesting stuff going on for me. It just felt like some rehashed ideas from previous tracks that just weren't as impactful. So yeah, not the greatest. Definitely my least favorite. Ooh, the sax. Okay, Tyler, you know I love the sax. This feels like some Call Me If You Get Lost type stuff. What is that instrument called? I can't remember what it's called, but I'm liking it. Okay, definite like Flower Boy, Igor, Call Me If You Get Lost vibes. Callie? I like that drum fill. That's super sick. The transitions on this album are really good. So yeah, definitely a track reminiscent of modern Tyler, I'll say, but I don't think it's as good as his new stuff. Like, it's definitely got that soul kind of R&B jazzy type vibe to it, with the synths, the piano chords, the nice vocals, but I just don't think it was as strong as stuff we've seen from Tyler in that style. So would I come back to it? No. But in the context of this album and in the context of when this came out, I think it's pretty solid. It's kind of interesting though, because it's definitely a different vibe. So it's going to be interesting to see how that ties into the flow of the album. Because I mean, we had that short track before. I don't know. We'll see. He's still gotta throw the synth chords or the piano chords in there. Yeah. Why does this have like kind of like a dance like energy to it? There's the synths. I feel like I'm in like a hurricane or some sort of tornado right now. But then it's crazy. This is crazy. It's like I'm in a hurricane, but then there's these moments of like clarity, or I guess it would be like the calm before the storm, or like the eye of the hurricane, you know? That moment where it's a little bit peaceful and serene, but then it goes straight back into that just pounding bass synth, I guess? I don't even know what it really is. It's just super distorted. This is gonna be a very divisive track. I feel like probably when this came out, this was a very love it or hate it track. And I don't know where I stand yet. I gotta let it finish. Right now, I'm just a little bit confused. And then this has like a weird, like, clubby, like, house kind of feeling to it. I don't know what's happening. This is insane. It's so blown out. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Okay, that track was an adventure. Feels like a hurricane, with just debris being freaking thrown around and just, oh my goodness, that was loud, abrasive, aggressive, in your face. I think I love it. Like, as it went on, it really grew on me. I really got into the flow of his flow, and I could actually, like, pick up on certain things. Like, at the beginning, I just heard a wall of sound, but as it went on, I heard the drums, I heard some synths coming in, I heard his vocals and the flow and what he was actually saying, and then you had those female vocals coming in too that added to that classic kind of Tyler feel. It's crazy how in a song like that, he can just throw in these jazzy little synth and piano chords, and it just works somehow. And I like that ending too, where it all, like, kind of dies down, the storm is dying down, and then he gets in his car. Yeah, just a really immersive track. It really put me in this state of confusion. Crazy track. I think I love it. I want to hear what that sounds like in a car or just on some nice speakers, because it's loud. It's insane. It's kind of like that, what's that XXXTentacion song, Look at Me, I think. That was like his breakout hit, and it had that super, like, bass boosted kind of meme style to it. This kind of had that same kind of vibe to it, but I really enjoyed it. Really enjoyed it. Caught some lyrics in there that I really liked too. Yeah, I don't know if I would listen to that, just chill, just listen to that. I might listen to it to get hyped or something. I don't know. I feel like it's a very specific time when I would actually listen to that. But for what it was, really enjoyed it. Immersive experience. Overall, a solid, solid track. So yeah, let's keep going. Say your pussy tighter than door hinges. Okay, Tyler. I don't know why I picked up the mic. Kind of a weird line, but I don't know. I feel like these tracks don't know what they want to be. Like, specifically this one, like, it's kind of sitting on that line between something super, like, distorted, like that last track, and his newer stuff, that more jazzy style. Like, I feel like it should just pick either or. It's kind of sitting in a weird middle place, middle ground. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how it progresses. And then I'll hate on it. Whoever that is. I like that. I don't like those sounds. Do not like those sounds, though, Tyler. Come on. I don't need some ASMR. These transitions are next level, bro. Yeah, not a huge fan of that track, honestly. Like, I feel like if you're gonna go, like, choose a direction. Like, if you're gonna go the distorted, crazy way, do that track before, the crazy one. If you're gonna go a more sensual, love ballad type, jazzy soul track, just go fully into that, lean into that. It's this weird kind of fusion and this middle in between, middle ground area, gray area that he's sitting in that I'm just not, like, a huge fan of. Also, I know The Weeknd did this in his recent album too, with the kind of Dawn FM radio. I know Tyler's done it in, I think he did it in Wolf, right? There were some portions in Flower Boy. I've never been a huge fan of it. Like, it just doesn't really add to the immersive experience for me, at least. It doesn't really take away either. It's just kind of there. That's just a little nitpick that I have. I've never been, like, a huge fan of these radio kind of skits, either at the beginning or an end of a track. Just doesn't really do it for me. And that track in general didn't really do it for me. Man, this video is gonna get tons of hate because I said something negative about Tyler, the Creator. I can already tell the Tyler fans are gonna be coming at me, coming at my throat, but I don't care. Okay, that's my response. That's my rebuttal. See, my shit is a sock. I used to piss in a pot, and now I piss on the wall. The strings. This is what I wanted. This is, like, really leaning into that jazzy soul feel. I like that little melody. That's dope.
You roll my window up.
Why? Damn.
Because it's windy.
I love it when you have
That was like an interlude skit that worked because it was funny, you know? Speaking of Mac DeMarco, I gotta do some of his stuff soon. Because he is one of, like, the biggest indie artists out there. So, yeah, that just kind of reminded me of it. But I'm really liking this track. We got the kind of the two halves here with a little funny little skit in between. Like, those, that works a lot better than the radio ones, in my opinion, because it showcases Tyler's, like, personality and him being funny, I guess, which is what Tyler's kind of known for. So, yeah, I'm really, the first half was super sick. The second half, I'm really, like, I'm getting, like, almost like Kevin Abstract vocal vibes from this, but obviously Kevin's stuff came out later, so Kevin was influenced by this, but that's what it's kind of reminding me of, is Kevin Abstract, maybe some like American Boyfriend stuff with the pitched up vocals and kind of just what he's singing about and the little cadence that he's going into here. Don't you dare play the radio. Don't you dare, Tyler.
Yeah, man. What's good? You good?
See, these skits are way better.
My nigga T, man. What's good, man? You good? All right. I see you. I see you with your little girl. She looks okay. All right, y'all.
Yeah, she is.
God damn it. I still fuck. Oh, you the
motherfucking man. Okay. Like I said, great track. Love the two halves to it. Really leaned into that jazzy soul feeling that I feel like other track was kind of sitting on the fence with. Yeah, it was a long track, but it was enjoyable. Didn't really get bored throughout it. The skits were entertaining. The skit in the middle kind of worked as a nice, like, palate cleanser, I guess you'd say. And then that skit at the end was funny as well. So yeah, overall, just a great track. I'm enjoying this album more than I thought I would, honestly, because I've heard some negative stuff about this album. But yeah, it's pretty solid. You can definitely see the kind of the maturing, the maturation of Tyler, I guess. Not completely in this album, but you can see where it's going, because obviously Flower Boy came out after this. Yeah, let's continue. This is like some JPEG Mafia type production. 30 Seconds. Okay, I never knew that Jared Leto was the lead singer of 30 Seconds to Mars. That bar obviously reminded me of that 30 Seconds, like Jared, or like Leto, or whatever he said. Yeah, that was weird. I was watching, I think it was maybe a Brad Taste in Music video, and 30 Seconds to Mars was brought up for some reason, and then he said something about Jared Leto, which is crazy, because, I don't know, it's just weird that Jared Leto is the lead singer of 30 Seconds to Mars. It kind of blew my mind for some reason. A nigga get some fucking chaos in her, I'm the truth in the dirt, get your ass just like a kick in the snare. It's no biggie, it's the G-O, L-F-E, go, no, no, no. That descending synth is so good. This is hard, holy. This flow is sick, too. I like these simple little synth melodies happening. Whoa. Another great transition. Not gonna talk too much about that track because it was another kind of just aggressive banger. But yeah, I thought it nailed that aggressive sound really good. Liked those little simple but really effective synth melodies in there. And then there were some other ones too. Yeah, just a banger. Really enjoyed it. Really liked that feature at the feature at the end there. Got me hyped. It was a headbanger. This chorus is great. This track's kind of a drag. I've got to be honest. It's only halfway done. Alright, I'm pretty sure I yawned 3 times during that track, so that just tells you pretty much everything I think about that track. It was a drag. It was too long. It really was not doing it for me. And I think, I don't know too much about mastering, but I think it came down to a mastering issue. It just felt super blown out, and like, maybe it was a mixing issue. I don't know too much about that stuff, okay? I'm not a freaking music producer, okay? I'm just a guy who sits here and hates on music because he has nothing better to do. But I'm pretty sure that's what it was. Like, it just felt like the highs were like super blown out and too loud, and like the vocal, like it just, it didn't mesh together that well, you know? So yeah, definitely not my favorite. Not like the worst thing I've ever heard, but definitely not one of the better ones on this album. They say I'm nutty, I'm picnic basket, I'm short of a sandwich, peanut butter, what's Watkins a fact, please come and get me, said I suck. Cherry Bomb, the greatest fucking album since the days of sound, and that shit gon' pop just like that nigga that was never round. I mean, you heard it here first from Tyler himself, Cherry Bomb, the greatest album since the start of sound, he said, I think. I mean, I think that title belongs to a whole lot of Red, but, I mean, it's his album, so he can say it, I guess. It's like Tyler the Creator sweating Jesus juice, dang. He's really flexing on this track. Tyler the Creator sweating Jesus juice. Yeah, definitely a flex track here. I don't know if it's quite earned at this point. I mean, he flexed a lot on Call Me If You Get Lost, but at that point it felt like it was earned. I mean, I like the self-confidence, that's all I'll say. Checks, but I'm the only nigga to ever check. Is that Kanye? Is this the toxic husband, Kanye? You can't lynch Marshawn, Tom Brady throwing to me. That was a sick bar. You can't lynch Marshawn. Nice little word play there. So yeah, we got the toxic divorced husband Kanye here. He does fit well over this beat, but all I can think about is his Instagram post recently. If you guys haven't seen Kanye's Instagram posts, I mean, you probably have because you're in the music community, I'm guessing, if you're watching this video. Man's kind of going crazy right now. It's bordering on the side of harassment with the private conversations that he's posting, what he's saying about Pete Davidson and Kim and all that kind of stuff. It's not a great look. It's not a great look for Kanye. And yes, it could be just promotion for his upcoming album, which it probably is. But still, I don't know why you would want to damage your image, because I'm definitely losing respect for Kanye with these posts and what he's been doing. I mean, I guess whatever you got to do to get some clicks, to get some streams. But at the same, like, Kanye, you don't have to do that. You're Kanye West. People are going to listen to your album. You don't have to destroy your reputation and make people think less of you just to get some extra streams. Like, I'm going to listen to your album anyways. There's another tangent there. I might make a video talking about the Kanye situation, because anybody who defends Kanye right now is an absolute brainwashed idiot that doesn't know anything. There's no way you can defend what he's posting on his Instagram right now. Like, unless you're a 12-year-old, which most of them probably are, even if you're 12, you should understand that this is not how you go about anything. It's not how you go about a divorce. It's not how you go about, like, he's acting like a high schooler. I don't know. I gotta stop talking about it. I'm just gonna try and enjoy this Kanye verse for what it is. But I mean, yeah, Kanye, he's been acting like a clown recently. He's a really good rapper though, holy. I just spent like 5 minutes hating on Kanye, but then he just does a great verse, like. And Lil Wayne got the star power on this track. Shout out to Donald Sterling, boy, let's get a scrimmage and cut some niggas. I bring the Clippers and a couple owners. That Clippers reference? Okay, I know I was kind of ripping on Kanye a little bit there, but Kanye's verse was great. Lil Wayne's verse was great. Heavy, heavy star power on that track. One of my favorites. I don't know why I left the S off of favorites. One of my favorites off the album so far, definitely. Beat was sick. It didn't seem like their verses had much, like, of a theme throughout them. It just felt like a bunch of funny, like, bars and one-liners and stuff. That Donald Sterling Clippers line by Tyler was really good. Kanye had some funny lines. Lil Wayne had some great bars in there. Yeah, just a good, like, posse cut with a good beat behind it. And, super entertaining. As much as I don't like Kanye right now, I cannot deny that he is still... He's a good rapper. He's still pretty talented. He's Kanye West. So yeah. Two more tracks here. Let's see how this thing finishes out. This is strange. Really, really weird. Keep the hoes. This is ridiculous, man. Okay. That track was insane. All over the place. So much stuff going on. Almost too much stuff going on, honestly. Like, ow, ow, hit my knee on the freaking table. Yeah, I mean, it kind of went back to that idea of Find Your Wings, which was a theme in an earlier track. But in terms of the sound, chaotic. Like I said, just hard to pin down, really. I don't even really remember all the stuff that happened. Like I said, it was almost too much. It was like a whirlwind of all these just different sounds coming at me. Some crazy synth stuff, some heavy bass in there, some crazy vocals, some pitched up vocals, some... I don't even remember how the track started, to be honest. So yeah, maybe just a little bit too many ideas in that one track, but yeah, I really do respect the ambition on this album. That's always been a thing that I do respect about Tyler, even if the ideas don't really work. I mean, he's trying some crazy stuff, and he's not like, these definitely aren't some radio hits on here, and they're not like your formulaic tracks. He's trying some new, different things. They don't always work. When they do, it's good. When they don't, you can still kind of respect it, at least, for the attempt and for the ambition and for... just the artistry in general and the creativity. So yeah, we're going into the last track here. I'm interested to see how this ends up. I'm guessing it's going to be similar to a lot of the tracks on here. I don't think we're going to get like a super drastic switch up. But yeah, let's just see. Let's go. Pack your bags, pack your bags. Okay. This track again is kind of a drag. Tyler's kind of a horny dude on this album. We've had a couple of these tracks. There you go. Tyler the Creator. Cherry Bomb. That last track was kind of too long for me. Too much of a drag, honestly. I did really like the lyrical sentiment of it, and I liked the kind of freeing feeling that was being portrayed in the lyrics with that line, I've got my own wings so I don't have to buy a ticket, and then that take me away kind of refrain there. Kind of this idea of traveling, running away, which was kind of, I mean, there was definitely a theme of travel and Call Me If You Get Lost too. So I really do like the lyrics on that last track. It was just a bit too long, too much of a drag, and I just got kind of too bored. So not one of my favorites. But overall, this album was pretty quality, pretty solid. Definitely better than I thought it was gonna be. There's definitely some tracks in here that I thought could have been a lot better, maybe shorter too. A lot of long tracks on here that could have been trimmed down a little bit. And the tracks where he was going for his modern sound now, the sound that he does now, they were nice at times, but they're just not to the same level as what he's doing now and what he did on Igor and Flower Boy. I wouldn't really listen to those over anything on those three albums that I've been mentioning the entire video. So yeah, and there was also points where he was kind of sitting on a in-between kind of area between this distorted, blown out sound, aggressive sound, and that newer sound that he's been doing. Like I expressed that issue that I had with a couple of the tracks. Overall, I do like the writing on this album. I've always liked Tyler's writing. I love how vulnerable and honest and introspective Tyler is within his writing. And I like the aggression on here too. There's some hard-hitting bangers on here. The production throughout the entire thing, it is pretty cohesive, I feel like, in terms of the production and the sounds. I feel like especially the production on this and the mixing and the mastering, it's either you're gonna love it, you're gonna hate it. For the most part, I loved it. There was a couple tracks where I feel like it was a little bit maybe too distorted and a little bit too just blown out and that kind of stuff. So yeah, sometimes he did take it too far, but in general, I feel like it fit Tyler's aesthetic, and it's definitely something he was going for. It's not like he accidentally just made the production terrible. Like, he's going for this sound, this rough kind of sound. Yeah, overall, in general, I like it. I like the flow of the album too. There's some slower cuts on here. There's some bangers. There's some introspective ones. There's that posse cut with Kanye and Lil Wayne where they just spit some bars, you know? So overall, a pretty well-rounded album, in my opinion at least. It's definitely not one of his best albums. Definitely not. If I had to rank it right now, I would probably... I don't know if I would put it under Wolf. It's definitely below Flower Boy, Igor, and Call Me If You Get Lost. I just don't know if it's below Wolf. I haven't listened to Wolf in a while. I haven't really listened to it since I did that reaction. I gotta listen to that more. But right now, I think I would say I like it more than Wolf. I think there's just more memorable moments, in my opinion, on this. So yeah, that's gonna do it for this video. Tyler, the Creator's Cherry Bomb. Is it the greatest album since the beginning of sound? Probably not. But is it an album? Yes, it is. It's an album. It's music.